Hello everybody and welcome to a very quick introduction to the update 1.7 of Euro Truck Simulator 2. The basic update involves the Volvo FH and FH16 truck models. So I've gone ahead and I've kind of set up a test here just so that I can pop in and see what model is issued to me off the bat. And it's the FH16, which is really nice. I'm just going to pop in here to the audio and do something with this music, which is really unnecessarily loud. We're just going to kind of pop into the truck. You cannot move freely because you don't have a truck to drive. You could purchase one or take one from the fleet. Okay, let's see if we can find the FH16 here. Yeah, we can. There it is. So we'll take this job. I don't think we're going to be going very far. What we do want to do is we want to pop outside and have a look at this machine and see what it's like. Let's get rid of a few of these unnecessary windows on the screen. So this is an up close look at it's a 700 horsepower model, this particular one. Looks like it's a 4x2x2 or whatever format the rear axle wheels are. There's two drive wheels and two carries. Not sure about all the details on this, but hopping back into the cab, she's very nice inside. It looks quite nice, it looks quite neat. I'm not sure exactly what this model is, but starting her up, we've got a very nice console here. Actually, I'm liking this quite nicely. You have temperature, fuel, and a fuel warning, a reserve fuel, I guess that is there. I'm not sure. 399 liters in her for now. GPS built into the dash. Kind of looks a bit odd, to be honest with you, the GPS for some reason. Just, it looks like the top of it is flush with the console itself. So, yeah, kind of not sure about that, if I'm to be kind of brutally honest. But it's a minor thing. Where's our handbrake knob? Well, there it is. It shows up red and goes back. So that's kind of nice. Lights should be on. That makes a bit of a difference to the dash. And popping outside to have a look at the lights. That's the full lights. That's lights off. There's our beepers. That's the low lights, high lights, and full lights. So it is quite nice. We do have a drive indication. We're at gear number one, and we're ready to move away. Mirrors are cool, actually. They're a bit different in shape, but they're good. And this is going to be a short delivery, but she does have a nice sound to her. She's 700 horses, so she won't be a problem pulling up the hill. Yeah. Oh, what are you doing here? Horn is a bit weak, but I won't be using it that much anyway. Sound is quite nice. She's an automatic box. That's the only thing I like. There's 105,000 kilometers on this truck already. So yeah, I don't know if I'm. I think I am. You know, reviewing the new truck that's in there, because this just looks new to me. Got a new mail. I've got 3 hours of driving to do, actually, so it'll be a short one. I mean, it has to be because it's in the game. So the other FH16s that I've driven have been mods. And I think I did have one downloaded originally, but I've taken it off. Well, maybe it's actually still in my other profile. I'm not sure. But anyway, this is the legitimate in-game SCS developed version, and it's nice. It's nice. I think I'll be very happy because I should be able to go and just buy it straight out when I get up there. But I thought that I just wanted to get in to the cab here and have a bit of a drive, get a bit of a look around, get a bit of a feel for this truck. Kind of considering it like a test drive well in advance of being in a position to purchase one. If you kind of want to put this into some kind of a, you know, a simulation type mindset, I'm just having a go for a day doing a trip just to get a feel for it, and all this is saying to me is I'm looking forward to it. It's kind of snazzy in here. I like the steering wheel. I'm not sure the color is going to be, well, why not? I mean, you keep the truck clean and make a bit of an effort, and it's quite nice and light in here. If there's a darker option, I'll probably choose it. Just because. Now, there's our kind of speed cruise control option. These are our temperatures, which I don't know, our pressures actually, looks like, which I don't think change very much. This is our fuel situation. And this is our fuel consumption, so the consumption is in there. So that's all good. We'll just lock that on to that speed there. That truck behind me is not making any effort to come across, so I'll get in front of him now. So the fuel consumption is carried over, as you'd expect. Yeah. The dash down here is looking nice enough. The car is just going to come out. It's predictable. Yeah, everything is pretty sweet overall. And I think I shall enjoy having a drive of this here truck. Obviously, I don't believe that the AI has been updated in this update. That might have been a little bit too much to have expected, I think. Ooh, I dropped a gear there. So that's an update that's going to come a little bit later, which is okay. I'm happy to wait. Because I get on quite well, I think, with the AI. There's a few things that I've gotten used to now. I'm aware of what they're going to do, and it's, you know, they're not surprising me anymore. And it's kind of okay the first time they do it, because it's maybe what you might expect. But when they're doing it every single time, then in the same location, blah blah blah, it gets a little bit tedious. But I'm still okay to wait for a while until the developer is ready to release something that is of a quality that they're comfortable with. And I also think that the fact that they're putting this release out as a new truck, even though there's a huge amount of mods out there already covering much of the stuff, you know, it's a good thing to do, because as they've said in their blog, there's a lot of people out there who haven't downloaded mods through, you know, for whatever reason. They're not anti-mod necessarily, maybe some of them don't like mods, whatever, but they're not doing it, and now they have the opportunity to drive a new model Volvo in the game, officially, so to speak, if you have to consider the modifications as unofficial updates to the game. But, you know, that's what they are. I don't really care about the mail. They're unofficial, sure, but they're sanctioned almost by the way SES is operating, you know. And seriously, we could do a little bit better on the horn, though. But that's just me. Oh, God. AI. This is predictable as well. And he'll get going now, and he'll try and pull over into another lane. Not that he really needs to. But I do need to look around me now, because we'll let him go. Now, he didn't go because I gave him a flash. He was going anyway. And I knew that, so I just timed it and made it look like I was flashing to let him out. That's all a bit of fun. I don't really care about the new mail. They're only going to tell me something that I don't need to know anyway. Right, so we have just a little bit more of a journey to go. This will knock off in a few minutes. And then we'll have made a delivery in my test environment. Which is the original map, the update to 1.7. It has the Going East DLC, but that's all. And we're kind of going along as normal. We are speed limited to 90, I think. We should be anyway. Let's just floor it a little bit more and see what happens before we get to the hill. Although this hill is not really going to stop us because... Well, it is, actually. We've lost 10. But we'll get to run underneath here now and see if we can... See if we can overrun. But I think we're limited to 90 as usual. But that's okay. We'll tick along here at 85. Just going to do one thing. This will take a very quick second. So what I did was I just upped my volume ever so slightly because I noticed that you weren't really getting the rumble from the engine so much, and the engine actually sounds quite good. I'm still going over the Cylon strip. By your command. I don't think they say that in the new movie, but it was in the original series. Which was cool. Yeah. Mirrors are kind of funky. They're decent though as well. They're perfectly good to be able to have a good view and see a good stretch back. I haven't adjusted the mirrors at all, however. I've just left them as they came with the truck. But they'd be nice. And yeah, the GPS is okay. The GPS is fine. It just did look like, before I turned the lights on, we can turn the lights off and see this at repeat. It just looked like it was in a kind of a funny frame in the dash. And maybe that's just the way the sun was shining on it or something. But it's in a really nice location, the GPS. It kind of falls to your eye quite quickly without really you need to take your eye off the road or look over too far. So I'm pleased with that. Clock up there, it's 12:37, 27 degrees, so we're in nice weather. And is this the same AI? No, it's not, it's a different car. But they have the same problems in this lane, which is why I'm choosing a different one now. See, but they'll probably all just stop and make a disaster of the... I don't care about these emails. We'll just drive forward, man. You do get a little whistle from the turbo, which is nice. And the steering wheel is actually nicer than the Mercedes that I'm driving in my main profile. It's just more consistent in its graphics. There's one or two things on the steering wheel in the Mercedes mod that I'm doing, which look like they're images that have been grafted onto the steering wheel in the mod, And yeah, for sure the AI hasn't been updated, because look at what's going on here. Bob is still trying to drive out onto the road. Please. And you know, just on the steering wheel here, they look a little more, the colours and the shape of it, or the feel of it, in terms of colour, just looks a little bit more homogeneous. So you know, so we're picking up on minor things here, but nevertheless, they're there. The rain sensor is on, and I think a lot of these are available already within the mods that I've seen for the Volvo, that have been out for the last year or so. There's probably just some of the internal detailing here that is, you know, slightly different here and there, but it's by and large, yeah, a really, really nice add-on to officially have in the game. It looks good, it sounds good, it drives well, and it will be, I think, a future truck of mine. I'll probably just spend the money and go straight to get the top range model. See if I get an 8x4 at the back, or a 6x2 by... I don't remember how the wheel chassis numbering is on trucks. You've got it's kind of steering and then drive wheels, right? And an 8x4, no, 8 is drive, 8x2x6, ah shit, I have no idea. Anyway, we will we'll go and spend as much money as we possibly can to get the best truck we possibly can within the game. And I'll probably do a bit of messing around here, you know, and just make a decision then. The really cool thing is that with the official game supported, you know, I can get my own number plates on and do a few little things like that, which, you know, which is pretty neat. And it'll tie in with the world of trucks quite well as well. Make that all a little bit more tidy and fitting together. You know, so that's kind of good. Of course, you know, I don't know where SES are with the negotiations with the Mercedes truck company, who still apparently haven't given their okay to use the Mercedes logo in the game. To be honest with you, it's not the end of the world for me, because the mods are out there. And if the Majestic truck is built to be awesome, but it doesn't carry the logo and some of the names of on the front, and by names I mean some of the serial numbers, you know, that's not a problem as well, because a friendly modder near you won't take too long to update that element of stuff. In fact, the updates are already there. So the problem is solved. And then everybody's happy. Thank you for letting me out, even though I don't think you did it on purpose, but I think we're going in here to full speed. We are too. Well, the delivery is just about to end, and this is the Volvo truck driving in here. I'm not very used to this, but we can maybe get to there without bumping into something. Get the reverse and back it up. Now that's the steering wheel on the back, okay. Yes, 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 show results now, that's fine. Start up there, great, apply. Getting it back in. Oh no, I can't do that because it's one of these things, okay. Alright, well, sorry, that was a rather sudden and unintended end to the video, but there it is. That is the truck. I don't have anything to photograph. Switch to photo mode. You cannot take pictures because you don't have one. Well, that suppose is fairly logical. But we're looking at a really nice example of a 4x2, and I think that's because there's four drive wheels in the back and two steering. So the other one would have been a 4x4 or something. I never understood it. But really happy with this update. Thank you very much to SES. It should be automatically uploaded onto your Steam, and it should be available for the non-Steam players very, very soon. So until the next time, go handy.